To prepare autonomy for right-handed use, remove the instrument from the package, grasp the angle locking mechanism at the base of the locking lever, and rotate the white ring to the left, until the arrow aligns with the seam and the blue locking lever is under the right index finger. For left-handed use, continue to rotate the ring until the blue lever is under the left index finger and the arrow is aligned with the seam. Hold the autonomy handle with your hand choked up, your thumb and forefinger on the blue rotation knob. Your middle finger actuates the jaw, and the ring and pinky secure the handle. Squeezing the lever halfway until you hear a click locks the jaw. Squeezing all the way releases the jaw. Autonomy's wrist is controlled by leaning against the port. As you lean your hand to the left, the tip of the instrument will turn to the right. Likewise, as you lean your hand to the right, the tip of the instrument will turn to the left. Up and down motions of the instrument tip are controlled in the same manner. The first step of the training program is learning to control the angle of the autonomy instrument tip. Try aligning the tip of the instrument against the four edges of the square board and hold it there. Practice until you can perform this task comfortably. Using the autonomy needle holder, pick up each of the four pegs on the board in row 1 and move them to the holes in row 2. As you move the pegs from row 2 to row 3, also flip the peg by rotating the blue rotation knob with your thumb and forefinger. Repeat as necessary. Grab the free washer with the jaws and thread the washer over the S-shaped track of the hook trainer. Articulate the distal tip of the needle holder so that it is parallel to the plane of the board and perpendicular to the path of the track. While maintaining this orientation, pass the washer over the curvature of the track and back. Repeat this task on the other side. Grab the washer attached to the rubber band with the jaws and perform the same task as in the previous step. Again, while maintaining the parallel and perpendicular orientation of the jaw, pass the washer over the curvature of the track of the trainer and back off again. You will notice that you need to compensate for the resistant force of the rubber band in order to maintain the parallel and perpendicular orientation of the jaw. At a right angle to the tissue pad, pick up the needle using the autonomy needle holder, being sure to hold the needle 3/4 of the way back from its tip and perpendicular to the jaw of the needle holder. Once the needle is properly loaded, drive the needle into and out of the target dots on the suture pad. Please note that the jaw should be parallel and the needle should be perpendicular to the tissue plane. While maintaining the jaw angle, roll the needle through the tissue using the rotation feature of the autonomy needle holder while pushing across the tissue. Once the needle exits the pad, release the back edge of the needle and re-grasp it at the exit point with the needle holder. Again, make certain to maintain the parallel and perpendicular approach and roll the needle out in an atraumatic fashion using the rotation feature of the needle holder. Perform this task as well with and without the wrist lock feature of the autonomy needle holder. Pick up the needle off the suture pad with the autonomy needle holder. Drive the needle through the target dots and perform multiple knot tying. Although the video shows the step being performed with two autonomy needle holders, you can effectively perform the same task with a rigid assist device in your non-dominant hand.